Yo, what's going on, guys? It's A-Rawls and welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'm going to be going over the ultimate guide to performance, graphics, as well as in-game settings for your Dead by Daylight copy. This will be covering reshade, how to uncap your FPS, as well as other hidden secrets that you guys will not want to miss. I highly recommend sticking until the end to figure out how you guys can get the most out of your Dead by Daylight in 2023. I'm going to have all the links to everything that you guys will need in the description down below, and if you guys have any further questions, join the Discord or comment down below, and I'll be helping out as many of you guys as I can. With all that out of the way, let's hop right into this video. All right, so starting off, all you guys are going to want to do is go to the Windows search bar. Type in percent app data percent. There'll be a little folder that pops up right here. All you guys want to do is double click. Now, once you guys are here, you will see that you are in the roaming tab. So just click on app data again. Once you guys click on app data, you'll see local, low, and roaming. Click on local. Now from here, all you guys want to do is scroll until you see Dead by Daylight. Now, this might look a little bit different for you guys. If it says configure, it's just because I have an older version of Dead by Daylight currently installed. However, all you guys are going to want to do is click on saved, config. Now, this is where everything's changed. So if you guys don't know already, with this new mid-chapter update, they reset all of your settings. They didn't add anything new. For some reason, they just changed the name from Windows Client to Windows No Editor. So I'm going to show you guys how to fix it right now. If you guys did actually have custom game settings that you already had set and it just reset it, all you guys want to do is delete this file and then rename Windows No Editor to Windows Client. There is no other new file. So all you have to do is just rename. And you should be good. What I personally did was drag my Windows No Editor file into my Windows Client and just replace them. But it's much easier if you just want to retitle it to Windows Client. If you guys are on Epic Games, by the way, this doesn't affect you whatsoever. It's going to be the exact same. All you have to do is just click. Now for Steam, it's a little bit different. If you guys don't already know, in the mid-chapter update, they added a new file and it pretty much reset all of your graphics as well as binds and just overall settings for Dead by Daylight. So what you guys are going to want to do, instead of clicking Windows No Editor, just go to Windows Client, and then this will be where all of your INIs are. So the main INIs that we're going to be focusing on in this video is going to be game user settings, as well as the Engine.INI. So first off, make sure you right click, go to properties, and make sure this is not on read only. If it is on read only, just uncheck, click apply, and then okay. Another window should pop up, and it should just have a bunch of listed stuff. This might seem really confusing at the start, but it's super simple. At the very top here, this is all your graphics stuff. So if you guys want to have the best performance, I'm going to show you guys what you should do. So these could be on 3, 2, or 1, depending on what you actually have the preset set to. If you guys want the best FPS in your game, all you guys are going to want to do is go to view distance 0, anti-aliasing quality 0, shadow 0. Pretty much make everything 0 except for animation quality. Now, I'm pretty sure you might be able to get away with animation quality being 0, but I've had some weird buggy things happen in the past. So just to be safe, I'm going to keep this on 3. If you guys still want your game to look decent, don't worry, because putting this on 0 is pretty much just low graphics. It doesn't make anything look worse than it already is. For resolution quality, make sure this is at 100. I think it's default 64 or 62 or something like that. So just make sure that's up to 100. From here, I'm going to show you guys how to uncap your FPS. So there's a hard cap on FPS whenever you default launch Dead by Daylight, and you need to bypass it in these files here. What you guys are going to want to do first off is go to FPS limit. Make sure this is at 120. So it's probably going to be at 60 by default. Just make sure it's 120. Right here, you guys don't have to worry about frame rate limit. This is going to be default 0. Just keep it at 0. All right, now I'm going to show you how to disable the VSync, because if you guys have VSync enabled, but you put it at 120, it will actually just still cap your FPS at the 60, because that's what VSync does. You will see B use VSync equals, it should be capital T true. All you guys are going to want to do is just cancel it, capital F, and then type in false. This will turn off VSync and you'll still have that 120 FPS cap put on, because you can't go higher than 120 for some reason. The game just like can't handle it. I think it's just because it has spaghetti code, but yeah. Everything else should be all right. There are a couple of things that you guys might want to tweak, but like I said, just copy my settings. I'll leave my INI in the Google Drive down below in case you guys want to do it, but make sure your sensitivity is changed if you do so, because it will just copy exactly what my sense and volume is. From here, once you guys are done and happy with the settings that you've chose, whether you put this at 1 or whatever it is, go over here to the top left, file, go to save, now click X. From here, just click on it once, right click, properties. You'll see this little box here. Now what we actually want to do is click on read only. Now what this does is, in game, you won't be able to actually change any of the settings, and it will be stuck like that. So then if you misclick, but if you guys do end up messing something up, this tutorial will always be up, as well as my INI. All right, now for engine. So just like last time, go to properties, make sure it isn't on read only. Click apply, okay. Go over here. Now this will look really complicated, but the only thing you guys are gonna wanna do is just copy codes that I have in the description. So at the bottom here, there's going to be a bunch of things here. All you guys are going to need to copy is all this stuff right here at the bottom, such as disabling anti-aliasing, making sure that mouse acceleration is off, as well as just making your frame rate really nice. So I'm going to leave all these codes that you guys are going to need in the bottom, or you can just copy them. Copy paste these in. Make sure you click enter before you do it so then it doesn't stack on top. If you do mess up somehow, just click X and then restart it. All right, so copy paste this in. Once you guys have done that, click file, save. Now exit out of here. Right click this and then properties. Make sure it's on read only. All you guys are going to want to do if you are on Epic Games is click on EGS. This will bring you right to the game files here. The main ones we're focusing on in this video are game user settings as well as Engine.INI. Now from here, it's the exact same as the Steam. Okay, once you guys have finished getting your game settings and disabling anti-aliasing, uncapping your FPS, all that good stuff, you're just gonna wanna exit out of here. Now for the reshade portion of this, I will have my reshade files in the Google Drive as well. So everything you guys are gonna need is in the description. However, what you guys are gonna wanna do is go to the link down below, which is leading you to reshade. If you don't know what reshade is, it is an in-game software that is supported by behavior. So this isn't considered cheating whatsoever. It's a post-processing injector, which is actually perfectly safe. Injector is kind of a scary word, but in this case, it's literally just all for lighting and stuff. So you should be 100% fine. What you guys are gonna wanna do is just download it. It will bring you down to the bottom here. Just download reshade 5.8.0. But you guys are gonna wanna go to debitla-win64-shipping. Make sure it's a shipping one and not easy anti-cheat launcher. But regardless, just make sure that you're on the shipping one. Once you guys have done that, go next. Debitla is on DirectX 10, so just click on 10. DebitLA uses X 10, 11, 12, so click on this. Next. For me, I already have it installed, so it won't give you this screen. It should just give you where I click modify. I'm only going to need three with my reshade config, but if you guys want to install all of them, all you have to do is uncheck all and then check all over here in this blip. Everything else is unnecessary, but yeah. So for my reshade, all you need is standard SweetFX as well as AstroFX. Click next. From here, it should just say successfully installed reshade. Click the finish button to exit the setup tool. Guys, this is all you have to do to install it to your DebitLA, but I'm going to show you what it looks like when you launch the game with it. Whether you're on Epic Games or Steam, just launch your game. Now it should say press home to continue. When you guys click home, you will see this. For me, I do have a reshade thing installed right now. I'm going to show you guys how to install each INI. Skip the tutorial or use the tutorial if you guys really need to. But yeah, it shows Technicolor, Vibrance, and Clarity, because those are all the settings that I use, as well as Lift Gamma Gain. I will have all these settings that I have changed down below in case you don't want to download the INI and you just want to customize it yourself, but still use mine. But I'm going to scroll through really quick and you guys can just copy it. Or look in the description, like I said. Once you guys are happy with your reshade file, just click on performance and then click home again. All right, so just for a quick example of what my reshade config looks like compared to the normal game, this is the normal game right here. And then if I do turn on my reshade, this is what your game will turn into. Now in game, it does look a little bit different. In my opinion, it looks better, if anything. It is a good change nonetheless, because this is way too dark and depressing, and I'm just gonna get sad if I keep playing like this. How do you install my reshade config? It's super simple. It is different for Epic Games as well as Steam, but I'm going to start with Steam. All you guys want to do is go over to Program Files 86, double click this, scroll down until you see Steam, go down, Steam Apps. You want to go to DebitLA, Binaries, Win64, and right here is where you'd like to drop the reshade config. All right, now once you guys have dropped my config, the It's ARoz TTV preset.ini, you should be good to launch your game. From here, all you guys are going to want to do is just backspace until it's nothing, and it should preset to show you all the INIs that are downloaded in that area. So for me, I'm going to use the It's ARoz TTV preset. Click select. If you guys are running the game with reshade and want the ultimate performance, make sure to just stick off performance mode before you launch into your game. What it does is it just makes it look cleaner and sharper, as well as use less resources, giving you better FPS. All right, for Epic Games, you guys want to do Program Files. Scroll down until you see Epic Games. DebitLA should be one of the options, depending on how many games you have installed. Click DebitLA. DebitLA one more time. Binaries, Epic Games Store, and then right here is your reshade config. Now, I already have presets here. However, all you guys are going to want to do is drag and drop the ones from your download into here. So just drag and drop the reshade file, and then you should be good to go. Now from here, launch DebitLA. But yeah, this is how you guys can get the best performance, best looking game, as well as the overall optimization for DebitLA 2023. If this video helped you guys at all, I highly recommend clicking the playlist that's on screen right now. It has every single DBD tutorial that I have made on how to get the most out of your DebitLA copy.